أهلا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله. The praise is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who is unique. The one who is indivisible. He does not produce offspring. لم يلد. Nor was he born. And none is equal to him. ليس كمثله شيء. لم يلد. والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the good mention of Allah is upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and upon his family وعلى آله وصحبه and upon his family and companion an abundant empathetic and actual peace. أما بعد and afterwards, for surely Allah the Most High sent all of His messengers. بعث الله الرسل من أجل لا إله إلا الله. For surely Allah the Most High sent all of His messengers with a statement, لا إله إلا الله. There is nothing worthy of worship but Allah. Like what Allah the Most High said. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعْبُدُونَ. And we did not send from the among us to the messengers from before you except we revealed to them truly there is nothing worthy of worship but me. فعبدون. So worship me. Al-Anbiya. Surah Al-Anbiya. Which is chapter 25 or ayah 25. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. And for sure we raise it in every nation messengers saying, that means we send to every nation a messenger, say in every nation, Allah said we sent to them a message saying, worship Allah, اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ. Worship Allah. وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. And leave false objects of worship. وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ. And leave false and leave off false of objects of worship. Jesus is false object of worship. Buddha is false object of worship. The cats and the dogs are false objects of worship. The idols and statues are false objects of worship. Because Allah said, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. And for sure, we raise it in every nation messenger, saying, worship Allah, and leave a false deities, false objects of worship. Surah An-Nahl, ayah number 36. وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا إِيهِ الطَّاغُوتَ. And just as Allah, the Most High, sent His messengers with La ilaha illallah, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam likewise sent to his messenger with La ilaha illallah, as narrated from Abu Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, that he said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam Mu'adh. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu, عندما بعثه إلى اليمن, when he sent to him to Yemen, إنك ستأتي قوما من أهل الكتاب, truly you will soon come to a people from the people of the book, فإذا جئتهم, so when you go to them, فادعوهم إلى أن يشهدوا أن لا إله إلا الله, call them to testify that there is nothing worthy of worship in truth but Allah, وأن محمدا رسول الله, and that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the messenger of Allah. To the end of the hadith, narrated Al-Bukhari. And this magnificent statement is the statement of Tawheed, Kalimat al-Tawheed, singling Allah out in worship, His perfect and beautiful names and attributes and His actions of lordship. وحدانية الله عبادته في أسمائه في صفاته. Due to Allah created the jinn and mankind, that means His actions of lordship. Due to it, Allah created the jinn and mankind. It means Allah created the jinn and mankind for the sake of La ilaha illallah. It means the wisdom behind the creation of the jinn and mankind is to testify that none has the right to be worshipped in truth but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, due to Allah, to it, Allah, means because of La ilaha illallah, Allah created the jinn and mankind. And He created the garden, Al-Jannah. خَلَقَ اللَّهُ الْجَنَّةَ وَالنَّارِ مِنْ أَجْلِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Allah created the garden, heaven, the paradise, and the fire, for the sake of La ilaha illallah. فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. That's in Akhirah. But in this life, فَمِنْكُمْ كَافِرٌ وَمِنْكُمْ مُؤْمِنٌ. Some among you are believers, while others are. Some are kuffar, some of you are kuffar, and some of you are mu'mineen. And that's in dunya. But in akhirah, فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. Means Allah Azza wa Jalla created the jinn and mankind for the sake of La ilaha illallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the garden. خَلَقَ اللَّهُ الْجَنَّةَ وَالنَّارِ مِنْ أَجْلِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Allah created that. Means those who believe La ilaha illallah will enter heaven, paradise, or garden, the Jannah. And those who reject to believe La ilaha illallah will enter hellfire. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. Allah Azza wa Jalla created the garden and the fire and legislated jihad. Allah made Shara Allahu al-jihad. Allah legislated jihad and commanding of known good and the forbiddance of the bad, and made lawful the lawful things and forbade the forbidden things. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala said, La ilaha illallah, it is the statement that the earth and the heavens were established for. خلق الله السماوات والأرض من أجل لا إله إلا الله. It means it is the statement that the earth and the heavens were established for. Upon it, Allah Azza wa Jalla originated all of the creations upon it. Means for the sake of La ilaha illallah. The religion was founded, and the prayers and the prayer direction was set up. The religion was founded means la ilaha illallah, هي أساس الإسلام, هي أساس الدين, the foundation of our deen, the foundation of Islam. Foundation of Islam is la ilaha illallah. Muhammad Rasulullah. We face the Qibla because of la ilaha illallah. The swords of jihad were unsheathed صيف الجهاد for the sake of la ilaha illallah. Anyone who stands and becomes obstacle and prevents the people to believe la ilaha illallah, the sword of jihad will be hayya ala al jihad, come on to the jihad. Means la ikraha fi al-deen, nobody is forcing you to believe la ilaha illallah or to believe accept Islam. But if you become an obstacle, if you prevent the people, if you stop from the people to believe la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, ya hayya ala al-jihad fi sabilillah. The terrorist groups like Al-Shabaab, Al-Qaeda, ISIS, those groups, they don't know the meaning of jihad. They are killing the Muslims. They are slaughtering the Muslims more than the kuffar. Those are devils, shayateen. They follow their lusts and desires. Look, this is a book. This book, look. Look, brothers. دلائل التحقيق والتوفيق في تحريم القتل بالتحريق. It is forbidden in Islam to kill by burning the people. Like Sob, terrorist attack. It is forbidden in Islam to kill, for burning the people, to burn the people. You can't burn the people with fire or artillery or gun or anything. How come you bring the people and you burn them with natural gas and nuclear bomb and chemicals? It's forbidden. Haram. We will talk another day, inshallah, ta'ala, that. But I'm giving you an example. The Al-Shabaab, they don't know the meaning of Islam. And who made Al-Shabaab or ISIS or Al-Qaeda? Amazon. The Western countries, the European countries, made them. They are the ones who gave them the weapons, food, clothing, ammunition, salary, everything, dress, and help them logistically. Yes. Anyhow, the swords of jihad were unsheathed, and it's the beauty right of Allah upon all of slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is all living beings. It is the statement that that protects the blood and the wealth and the offspring in this realm. Means when you say la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah will protect your wealth, will protect, la ilaha illallah will protect your blood. Nobody can shed your blood, nobody can kill you, nobody can take your wealth, nobody can wrong you, because la ilaha illallah protects you. أمرت أن أقاتل الناس حتى يشهدوا أن لا إله إلا الله فإذا قالوا يعني قالوها يعني قالوا لا إله إلا الله عصموا مني دماءهم وأموالهم وحسابهم على الله. And لا إله إلا الله is the rescuer from the banishment of the grave and the banishment of the fire. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم had a man making adhan, calling the prayer. Sayyina ashhadu an la ilaha Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allah is great, Allah is great. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship and truth except Allah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship and truth except Allah. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. I bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the messenger of Allah. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. I bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the messenger of Allah. حي على الصلاة. Come to the prayer. حي على الصلاة. Come to the prayer. حي على الفلاح. Come to the success. حي على الفلاح. Yes, Naima Love, you said drink lots of water. Yes, that's, you're right. I didn't drink a lot of water these days, yeah. حي على الفلاح. Come to the success. Come to the success. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allah is great, Allah is great. La ilaha illallah. I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship and truth except Allah. Yeah, and beings, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam may heard a man calling adhan, making adhan, calling, inviting the people to the prayer, calling the making the call of the prayer. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, bi abi anta wa ummi, ya Rasulullah, ya Habiballah, he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, sallu ala Rasulullah, say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, najawta min an-nar, najawta min an-nar. You've been rescued from hellfire. You're safe from hellfire. Yes, la ilaha illa is the rescuer from the banishment of the grave and the punishment of the hellfire. Najawta min an-nar. You've been saved. Allahumma najjina min adhab al-qabr. Allahumma najjina min an-nar. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-huda wa-t-tuqa wa-l-afaf wa-l-ghina. Allahumma inna na'udhu bika min al-kufri wa-l-faqri wa min adhab al-nar. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا. والله we have wronged ourselves. We have oppressed ourselves. وإن لم تغفر لنا. And if you do not forgive us. وترحمنا. If you do not give us your mercy. And you do not make your mercy upon us. لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Indeed. We will be among the losers. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ. رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ جَامِعُ النَّاسِ لِيَوْمٍ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد. ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين. وجعلنا للمتقين إماما. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الظالمين. ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الكافرين. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. اللهم اعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. ربنا أفرغ علينا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. Layla, I love this word. Wallahi, I like it. I love it, Layla. I love it. It's my blood and flesh. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم السد من كان آخر كلامه لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. Whoever says the last moment of his life, La ilaha illallah, will enter Jannah. Allahu Akbar. Will enter Jannah. So La ilaha illallah, my brothers and sisters, is the statement that protects us. The plant and the wealth and offspring in the stream. It is the rescuer from the banishment of the grave and the banishment of the hell. The fire is the permit. It is the permit which no one will enter the garden without. The robe which if one is not connected to it, he is not considered devoted to the means that connects one to Allah. La ilaha illallah, it is the statement of Islam. La ilaha illallah, hiya al-islamiyya kalimatul islamiyya asasul islam, the foundation of Islam. La ilaha illallah, hiya miftahul jannah, is the key to the abode of peace. The abode, the key to the abode of peace. Allahu yad'u ila dar as-salam. Allah is inviting you to the house of peace, al-Jannah. Allah is inviting you, is calling you to the house of peace. Jannah. Allah said, Lahum daru salam inda rabbihim. Al Jannah, the heaven, the paradise, is the reward of the mu'mineen. Their reward is Al Jannah, is daru salam. Their reward, the mu'mineen, their reward is daru salam, the house of peace. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al firdaus al a'la. Ya Rabb. نسألك الفردوس الأعلى. الفردوس الجنة. نعم. The robe which if one is not connected to it, he is not considered devoted to the means that connects one to Allah. La ilaha illallah, it is the statement of Islam and the key. افتاح الجنة. The key to the abode of peace, and with it the people are divided into the wretched and the happy. Because of La ilaha illallah, people will be only two groups. فَمِنْ شقي وسعيد. فمنكم شقي وسعيد. The wretched and the سعيد happy. فأما الذين شقوا ففي النار. Those who are wretched. The evildoers will enter hellfire. والعياذ بالله. وأما الذين سعيدوا ففي الجنة. And those who are happy will enter heaven. The house of peace. الجنة الجنة الجنة. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل الجنة يا رب. يا رب يا رحمن. يا رحمن. And divided, yes, with it, with the La ilaha illallah, the people are divided into the wretched and the happy. The accepted and the ones driven away. With La ilaha illallah, and with it, the land of disbelief and the land of the belief are distinguished. The land of belief. Darul Islam here, the land of belief. Darul Kufri is the land of disbelief. The land of belief and the land of disbelief. Yes. The land of belief and the land of disbelief. Darul Kufri wa Darul Islam. And with La ilaha illallah, the land of disbelief, Darul Kufr, and the land of belief, Darul Iman, are distinguished. The abode of joy and the abode of misery and lowness are discerned. La ilaha illallah is the supporting tenant that carries the fard and the sunnah. And whoever is last word is to be La ilaha illallah will enter the garden. Whoever is last word is to be La ilaha illallah will enter the garden. That means whoever says the last moment of his life, La ilaha illallah, will enter Jannah. Allahumma rizqna husnul khitam. We're asking Allah to give us good ending. Good ending. Husnul khitam. Good ending, my brothers and sisters. That is the point. إِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ لَيَعْمَلُ بِعَمَلِ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ. One of you will do the righteous deeds, the deeds of the people of the Jannah. حَتَّى مَا يَكُونُ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَهُ إِلَّا ذِرَاعٌ. When he is very close, when his death is very close, he will turn into the other side. فَيَعْمَلُ بِعَمَلِ أَهْلِ النَّارِ. Then he will do the deeds of the people of the Nair, of the hell. Before, he was doing the a'mal that will lead him to Jannah. The deeds that will lead him to Jannah. Praying, fasting, good to his parents, worshiping and singing out the worship to Allah. It's nice doing all good deeds. But when his death is very close, he's turning away. He's turning, changing to the opposite. And doing the evil deeds. Evil deeds. He will become evildoer. Not praying, not worshiping Allah, not fasting, he's not good to his parents, fornicating, drinking, gambling, doing all kinds of haram, zina, riba, usury, interest, every, all bad, negative, bad, haram things he's doing, eating the khanzir and bad things, drink drugs, eating, chewing cotton, drugs, and marijuana, marijuana, weeds, all evil things. And before he was sheikh, he was alim, he was good man, righteous man. And now he's doing all kinds of haram. Yes. نَعَدَكُمْ لَيَعْمَلُ بِعَمَلِ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ حَتَّى مَا يَكُونُ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَهَا إِلَّا ذِرَاعٌ فَيُصْبَغُ عَلَيْهِ الْكِتَابُ فَيَعْمَلُ بِعَمَلِ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ فَيَدْخُلُهُ.
وإن أحدكم ليعمل بعمل أهل النار. And one of you is doing the deeds of the people of the hellfire. But when his death is very close, he's changing. Then he's doing what? فيعمل بعمل أهل الجنة. Then he's doing the deeds of the people of the Jannah. Praying, fasting, reading Quran, making tawbah, seeking the forgiveness of Allah, making istighfar. Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. All good deeds. Then that will be his end. فيدخل هذا هو الانتر جنة. May Allah give us حسن الختام, good ending. The ulama said, the man who is doing righteous deeds in front of the people, or the appearance who looks like a righteous or sheikh or alim, from inside is evildoer. He doesn't have good intention. That's why he had a bad ending. سُؤُ الْخَاتِمَةِ. And the man who looks like, or who maybe the people think that he's asi, or moriyan, or he's doing bad things. Yes, he's doing, fornicating, doing all kinds of haram. But from inside, he's a real mu'min. He loves Allah. He loves his messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that saved him. So Allah gave him, because of that good intention, because he loves Allah, he loves Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah gave him good ending. Yes, innama al-a'mal bil-khawatim. The deeds are the ending. Yes, you can do pray, fast. How many people we have seen? They are moriyan, they are chirri, they are our kafiris. At the end, they are becoming devoted Muslims, devoted servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how many people you have seen, sisters or brothers, with beard, with Quran, with sunnah, with hijab, going to the masjid, inviting the people, making da'wah, doing all kinds. And then he's changing and becoming like a kafir. Drinking, gambling, yalsuq, bad, moriyan, chirri, day day. He's going to the bear to galay, our birthday galays. And before she was shikhat, or she was with head. But she had a bad ending because of no good intention. The intention. Nas'alullah yirzuqana husna al-qitam. We're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us good ending. Yes. We're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us good ending. All right. If the people are divided into the wretched and the happy, فَمِنْكُمْ شَقِيٌّ وَسَعِيدٌ. They accepted the ones, they accepted and the ones driven away. And with it, with La ilaha illallah, the land of disbelief and the land of belief are distinguished. The abode of joy and the abode of misery and loneliness. And loneliness are seen it. La ilaha illallah, it is the supporting tenet that carries the fard and the sunnah. And whoever is, last statement or last word is to be La ilaha illallah will enter Jannah, will enter the garden. From Abu Dawood. From Page 300. And surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah the Most High, ordered his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he fight the people over the statement of Allah. Tawheed. There is nothing worthy of worship but Allah. La ilaha illallah, it is the protection of the blood and wealth, like what is in the hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمِرْتُ أَنْ أُقَاتِلَ النَّاسَ. I was ordered that I fight the people حَتَّى يَشْهَدُوا أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, until they say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, and that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. And so whoever says لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, then for sure he has protected from me his self and his wealth, except with his right and his accounting is upon Allah, related by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. And as for the hadith of Miqdad bin Al-Aswad, that he said, Miqdad said, يا رسول الله أرأيت إن لقيت رجلا من الكفار فاقتتلنا فضرب إحدى يدي بالسيف فقطعها ثم لاذى مني بشجرة فقال أسلمت لله. قال وفي رواية فلما أهويت ليقتله قال لا إله إلا الله أقتله بعد أن قالها.
Look, Miqdad said, O Messenger of Allah, do you see that if I meet a man from the disbelievers and he was fighting us and he hit one of my hands with the sword and severed it, then he sought to protect himself from me with a tree. Then he said, I submit to Allah. Aslamtu lillah. I submit to Allah. وفي رواية فلما هويت ليقتله قال لا إله إلا الله. And in another narration, I wouldn't desire to kill him. He said, La ilaha illallah. Can I kill him? And after he said, La ilaha illallah. Can I kill him? After he said, La ilaha illallah. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا تقتله. رسول الله said, Don't kill him. قال يا رسول الله إنه قطع إحدى يدي. He said, O رسول الله, O Messenger of Allah, even if he cut off one of my hands. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تقتله. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Do not kill him. Do not kill him. لا تقتله. فإنه فإن قتلته. For if you kill him, فإنه بمنزلتك, then verily he will be in the station of you were in before you killed him. فإنه بمنزلتك قبل أن تقتله. If you kill him, that means he will be in your position. That means like a mu'min, like a believer. وإنك بمنزلته قبل أن يقول كلمته التي قال. And you will be the station he was in before he said the statement of he said. Means he will be your position and you will be his position. You'll be like a kafir and you'll be like a mu'min. So before you killed him, he was a kafir. No, before he say la ilaha, he was a kafir. So you will be in his position. And he will be your position. So does Al-Shabaab, do they understand it like this hadith? Do they understand that you can't kill someone who says La ilaha illallah? I remember the speech that the spokesperson man, Ali Dari, gave. The speech before the last speech. He said, we attacked Baridew and killed all the Somali soldiers, all Somali army, while they were praying. We killed them while they were making prayers, while they were praying. Are you going to Quran and go to Anabi al-Dari? No, as a Muslim. No, that is not Islam. That is haram. That's haram. You don't follow the true religion of Islam. Mr. Ali Dere, the spokesman of Al-Shabaab and Al-Qaeda. And from the greatest merits of the statement of Tawheed, La ilaha illallah, is that it obligates for the one who says it to enter Jannah and to be saved from eternity in the fire. It has come out from Al-Bukhari and Muslim. That means La ilaha illallah has a great great virtue. I'm so tired tonight. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ما من عبد قال لا إله إلا الله ثم مات على ذلك إلا دخل الجنة. قلت وإن زنى وإن سرق. قال وإن زنى وإن سرق. قلت وإن زنى وإن سرق. قال وإن زنى وإن سرق. قلت وإن زنى وإن سرق. وإن سرق. قال وإن رغم أنف أبي ذر. Look this beautiful hadith. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no one from the slave, he says La ilaha illallah, and then dies upon that, except that he will enter Jannah. That means anyone who says La ilaha illallah and dies, he will enter Jannah. He said, I said, even if he fornicates and even if he steals, that means even if he does zina, or if he steals, sariq, will he still enter Jannah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, even if he, wa in zina wa in sariq, even if he stays, even if he fornicates and even if he steals, he will enter Jannah. Even if he fornicates, and even if he steals, and even in spite of bidarda, yes, still he will enter Jannah. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "من قال لا إله إلا الله أنجده يوما من الدار وأصابه قبلها ما أصابه." No, whosoever said لا إله إلا الله to do in his time, his life, it will save him. And what affected him before will no longer affect him. Related by Al-Bukhari and Abdul Razak and Al-Albani. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من كان آخر كلامه لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. Whoever is last word is لا إله إلا الله will enter Jannah. My brothers, Muslims, and my sisters, the purpose of this speech is that you renew your covenant with La ilaha illallah and increase your adherence to La ilaha illallah and being sure of what La ilaha illallah indicates and that you worship by repeating. For in the hadith from that he said, I'm so sleepy, brothers and sisters in Islam. Last night I was sleeping inside my car and tonight I am sleeping in this beautiful hotel. وتلك الأيام نداولها بين الناس كل يوم هو في شأن. Yes, it is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, last night I slept inside my car and it was subhanallah raining and also all kinds of snow. Yes. Love you, brothers and sisters. I love you. You're so great. You're so nice. La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. sorry. Good night. Good night. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bye bye. 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 Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. All of you. Bye bye. Bye bye. Bye bye. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.